Thank you so much, Chairman Waters, for calling this important meeting and all of our panelists. I thank you for all of your comments, particularly those who talked about wanting to reduce overdraft fees that drain billions of dollars from America's poor and working class communities every year. The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau has found that overdraft fees cost our consumers over $15 billion in 2019 alone. And these fees disproportionately target and penalize low-income consumers. They found that almost 80% of overdraft and non-sufficient fund fees are borne by only 9% of consumers, and they are all financially vulnerable. While I'm glad to see some banks have taken some initiative by eliminating or moving in that direction, it's concerning to me that it's taken this long and that many banks still have yet to make any voluntary changes. And with banks enacting different policies, consumers are left with little consistency. They're very confused by these different policies. We must ensure that we have a comprehensive, permanent solution enacted to protect consumers. And that's why I have introduced the Overdraft Protection Act, which has been reported out of the committee. It builds on the Credit Card Bill of Rights, which passed in 2009, and according to the CFPB, has saved consumers over $16 billion a year by keeping fees in their pockets. I want to, in the consumers' pockets, I want to ask Bank of America and Citibank, because in your testimony, you talked about your actions to eliminate fees. Can you elaborate what product offerings have you changed to reduce or eliminate the overdraft fees? And can you speak to how your consumer banking division has remained profitable in light of all of these changes? First, Mr. Moynihan, and then Ms. Frazier.
So I think you heard many of my colleagues talk about this, and this is a product in the industry. The first is a no overdraft product, and especially for students and younger people. We have 4 million of those, and I think if you total it up across the board, that product allows people to have no overdraft capacity. Then you have the ability for other products for people to opt in, and what we've done is reduced our overdraft per occurrence fee from $35 to $10. We've reduced the no ability to have the NSF type fees, the numbers of occurrences. So all that totals up that we're down 60% second quarter last year, second quarter this year, and it'll fall further because a lot of those changes took place, and we recently announced that it's down 90%. But we're able to do that because of the scale and capabilities of our team in consumer banking. And these larger banks, in our variety of banks that participate in our system, there's a variety of business models. But one of the things that'll be consistent is the scale we've been able to achieve in our company and these companies at this table have allowed us to pass through those benefits as a consumer and still remain profitable.
Thank you, Ms. Frazier.
Thank you very much, Representative. Lovely to see you. We are proud at Citi to have eliminated overdraft fees and NSFs. This was the right decision for our bank and is reflective of a multi-year commitment to having a customer-friendly approach to fees. Similar to my colleague, Mr. Moynihan, we also have a product called the Access product that accounts for almost 20% of all of our accounts. In addition to the no overdraft, also is a very low cost, customer-friendly account that has been growing substantially over the last few years and played a very important role during the pandemic for those who are most affected. It's something that we're committed to continuing to grow. Thank you.
Well, I want to. Is there any other banks that can commit to eliminating overdraft fees altogether by 2025? Anyone else on the panel that can follow the leadership of these two banks? Then I'd like to move to the interest rates that are rising and causing problems or challenges with the housing market and making it harder for first-time home buyers to be able to take out mortgages. Again, I'd like to ask both Bank of America and Citibank what you have done. Do you have any programs or ideas of how we can make help facilitate home ownership, even with the challenges of increased interest rates? would be moving the 30-year mortgage to sort of a 50-year mortgage to lower the interest rate payments per month. Would that help? Any ideas that you may have? And after them, anyone else's ideas? First, Mr. Moynihan, then Ms. Frazier.
I think we have programs that provide down payment assistance and grants for that. If you get HUD counseling, we have programs to develop housing in our community. Develop program $6 billion a year we do in low-income housing development and other types of housing development. So it's a multifaceted thing. But I think in the end of the day, the amount of adjustment that will go on as rates adjust is intended to attack the inflation, and it will take a period of time for that to sort through.
Thank you. The gentlewoman's time has expired.